Hi, my name's Sheldon Livesey. I'm the director for a ministry called Of One Accord Ministry, and we serve most of the charitable things for two Appalachia East Tennessee counties, Hawkins and Hancock counties. We're sort of halfway between Bristol and Knoxville if you looked us up on a map. Well, something very significant happened recently, and I believe not only was it applicable for our location, it was applicable especially now for the Church of America, and I wanted to be able to speak that out to the intercessors across this nation, and I believe it will resonate with you. Okay, some months ago, not only do we have a community prayer network that meets on Monday nights, but we have a regional prayer network that meets on Friday nights. And at this time, we were rotating the locations of where Friday night was, and we host one of those. So we had the idea that because a lot of historical events had taken place in our community, that we would actually go to those places and I would give them a little bit of history about the place and see if God would show us, reveal to us anything about those locations. We went to a church on the site of which Francis Asbury preached, and then another site, and the one I'm talking about right now, was at one time, it was the state headquarters, the state capital for the state of Franklin for a short period of time. And it was a county seat for a county that at one time incorporated some 13 counties before they were carved off. We were part of North Carolina, then the state of Franklin, and then North Carolina and the territory south of the Ohio before we formed a state. In this courthouse location that's still standing, there were at least, it's been identified, 17 Indian treaties that were made and broken there. And we just felt like that was a good place to meet. Why was it a good place? Especially because it's a site of a church, and in that church, there was a tremendous revival going on in the late 80s and the 90s. And it sort of waned away, but we have had prophecies that it would be the site for the beginning of revival in East Tennessee. So anyway, we met together. As soon as we finished singing, it was time to pray. Guess what happened, friends? We've never had this happen, I don't believe, but the lights went out all up and down the highway. The lights to the church went out, and it was a night so dark that you could not even see where the windows were. Usually there's a little bit of light filters in through windows, but not this night. We were in total darkness, and we continued to pray. And sometimes, as it is when there's visions, I understand, I was facing the front. I didn't even know where I was facing. And I faced a side wall, and in that wall, in this vision, there was an arched doorway up here with golden light coming through, just like you would think of looking into heaven. And as soon as I was looking at this, I was just mesmerated at the beauty of this thing. The Lord spoke to me and He said, "This is the doorway for the answers for the church. This is the doorway for the answers for the church, and your answers are really quite simple." In other words, if you can see where this doorway is, if you can go in the door, the answers that the church is looking for in America is very, very simple. It's just you can't see them. And why is that? I soon found that out. Because in this vision, it was still going on, two big, tall demons marched in front of that doorway with a black veil, and they put it over the doorway, and total darkness once again. And then the Lord spoke to me again, and He says, "I want you to begin to pray that I release my warring angels to remove the demons and the veils so the Church of America can see the answers, the doorways, and go in and get their answers." Now, I believe more recently, we have seen other doorways that have been hidden by demons and the veils, behind which we've seen the works of darkness take place. They've been hidden to us. There's been networks. There's been all kinds of working and coming together, but the Christian church has not been able to see it because it's been behind the veils that have been hidden by demons. And we, the church, are supposed to be also praying that not only God remove the demons and the veils over the doors that are the answers for the church, but over those doorways behind which the workings of darkness has taken place, so that we can begin to see the networking, we can see the plan, we can see the plot, we can see all of that. All of it will be exposed, and all of it can, in God's timing, be dealt with. So I thought this would be very interesting for y'all. I have begun to pray every day that God would do just that, but I realize my prayer is very little compared to many prayers that can be praying with me, along with me, joining with me. If we join in agreement, two of us, three of us, and then 10, 20, 100, 1,000 of us, I believe we'll begin to see God exposing things that are beyond our belief. And we believe that we're standing on the precipice of the greatest revival, the greatest awakening that this world has ever known. I believe it's going to start, it's going to explode, it's going to be the revival that wraps things up, the revival that makes a church right now that is anything but spotless and unblemished. It's going to make us the spotless and unblemished bride for Jesus to come and to at whatever time He chooses to come, so that we will be ready for Him. So thank you so much for allowing me to share this with you today. God bless you, and you have a great day.